Denture duplication is integral to implant dentistry and removable and fixed prosthodontics in general. Knowing how to duplicate a denture effectively gives you the ability to produce a surgical guide on demand, as well as make a copy of a denture for a patient for a wedding that is on tomorrow. So let's learn how to duplicate a denture. What do we need? We need an alginate bowl and spatula. We need a sharp laboratory knife. Of course, we need our denture duplicating flasks. They come in a couple of sizes. This is the small one. This is a larger one. We need a pressure cooker. This is a water activated one. There's one that is activated on air. Vaseline. Repair acrylic with a proper bowl. Tooth colored acrylic with a proper bowl. And orthodontic resin, again with a proper bowl. And of course, the denture that we need to duplicate. First thing we do is Vaseline the inside of the flask. Vaseline everywhere, so you have a nice coat. Vaseline the joint, especially because once the acrylic gets in there, it will be a problem. Next, let's mix some alginate. Place the alginate inside the flask. Do not be afraid to overfill it and fill in the joint. Now let's take the denture, wet it, and place it in the center and gently press down. At this point, with your finger, gently remove the excess. And close the flask. So now we waited and the first part of the alginate is set. Leave the alginate in the joint. Let's go on and clean up. You trim to the edge of the denture. And the goal is to create a space where the extra acrylic is going to escape through. At this point, I'm going to take the denture out. And you want to make sure to remove any undercuts. You definitely don't want to leave a lip in there. You want to open it up. Wonderful. Now that we cleaned everything up, we're going to return the denture into its original position. And you can see how nicely this comes around. And I'm going to trim even a little bit more. And now what we're going to do is we're going to take some Vaseline and we're going to coat the alginate with Vaseline. Make sure you get a nice thin coat everywhere. Whether you get it on a denture or not, it doesn't really matter. One thing you want to make sure is that you get it all over the alginate. And let's mix alginate again. Let's put the alginate into the flask. And we go ahead and close. Remove the extra. And close and tighten. Well, all right, the alginate is set. Let's open it up and open the flask. And look at that. Lift up the denture, set it aside. And look at this, we have a beautiful duplication of the denture. If there are places with undercuts, such as here, trim it back a little bit. And here's our denture duplicating flask ready to go.
I love this. I have a beautiful denture duplicated in here, both surfaces, in a flask, nice and clean, and we're ready to make whatever it is that we want to make. Let's start by making a surgical guide. We're going to use clear orthodontic resin in order to duplicate the denture in it so we can make a surgical guide. Let's go. So we'll start by pouring some liquid resin into the bowl. And now we're going to pour it into the mold. Once you poured one member, you will pour the other side. Now that we filled both members, we can close the flask. And you're going to have to push all the acrylic out. Close the member and tighten. And of course, clean up as much as you possibly can. Now that we cleaned the acrylic up, we're going to go ahead, make sure we have enough water in the denture duplicating in the pressure cooker, and place the flask in it, add a little bit more water, and we're gonna close it. All right, we waited long enough for it to cure. Let's open up and get our flask. And here we go, the moment of truth. Clean up the extra, so we have a little bit of extra acrylic here. We don't have to do a lot of cleanup either because we squeezed the flask all the way. And now I'm going to take my knife and raise it up. And here we go. And we have a beautiful copy of the denture in clear ortho resin. And now we have a beautiful denture copy to make a surgical guide with.
And our patient has a wedding tomorrow. We need to make her a copy of a denture.
So we're going to start by mixing tooth colored acrylic. And we'll turn on our laboratory vibrator and make sure that it vibrates into every nook and cranny. It will cure in about 5 minutes and we'll get back to it. Now we let it set. We'll come back, gently pick up the white. Here we go, we got our teeth. And we're gonna go to the bench into the drill and remove the little bit of extra so we can flow the pink acrylic around it. Now we have a duplication in tooth shade acrylic, and we're going to lay that back into the mold. Now that we laid it into the mold, let's make sure that everything closes nicely. Perfect. This is ready for the application of the pink acrylic. Go ahead and close the flask as tight as we can. And we're going to go ahead and put this back into the pressure cooker. So let's open up our pressure cooker, get our flask. Et voila. And we have a beautiful duplicated denture. So denture duplication is key. Today, I do it digitally. Obviously, I will scan this and my laboratory can produce a beautiful milled or printed denture for me quickly. But knowing how to do this in the laboratory can save you time when you don't have a connection to the digital lab. Having this copy handy is excellent because you can produce a surgical guide, and we'll go over how to prepare this with the proper markers. And of course, a copy of the denture in the proper color. And this way we can use that during treatment or, like I said, for the wedding tomorrow. And last but not least, let's not forget, clean everything out. Take all the alginate and acrylic out. Make sure that you got it out of the seam, out of the hinge, and Vaseline a little bit on the inside, the way we did before. Close it and get ready for the next one. From Prosthodontics and Implant Surgery of Manhattan, where people come in with missing teeth and leave with winning smiles, I am Dr. Zev Kaufman.